Ranos here, and welcome to an episode of Space Engineers. Today, we're taking a look at three mods. The Sleek Corridors by... Enenra? That is blurry as hell. The Flat Collector by Sultan MRP. So we're going to do flat mod every single week. And the Zat Bedroom Pack by... zZatern. zZatern. Yeah, I kind of realised it's actually R-M, no, R-N, not an M. So yeah, spelled that wrong. Luckily in the previous video I did write it correctly in the description. So I'm putting it correctly here. Guess we'll have to do that. Anyway, how about we first take a look at the bedroom pack? Since it's the closest thing to us. So, first lesson. Now here, got the shelves, the bedside tables. And this one is a light variant. And then you've got just a regular table, another table, there, a wider table, and then the light on the other side. Now, this one is occupying this block. Can't see about the UI. No, it's occupying this block. That one's there, nothing in that one, that's occupying that side, that's occupying the other side, and that's occupying the left side. So, two variants of each to cover each side of the bed. Which are these beds. Now here is part of the bunk bed. So you've just got one little bed on the bottom. I don't have the sleep mod installed. And then these are the two top bunk beds. Now why are there two of them? Well, this one is occupying this block. Right here. But its physical collision model is right here. In the right where they're supposed to be. What? Interesting. I guess it didn't really matter its proper collision mode if this one's done correctly. But yeah, this one's occupying this block. That way, no matter where you put the bed, you'll always be able to put down the top bunk. Which is handy. And then we go to the other beds. First of all, let's head down here to the single beds. This one's got a bit of a cover on it. Similar to them, but much more height. So you get a lot more headroom. Okay. Then you got this one that doesn't have a top. That planet's quite far away, isn't it? Wrong bed. Then you got the bunk beds. Now these two are in the same style as those two. Well, you can see, only has a bed on one side and missing textures on the other. That's because this thing is meant to take up the other side. Now if I'm not mistaken, which side does that go onto? Oh, that's the bunk bed, no wonder. Yeah, and this one goes at the bottom of the bed, like this. And there you go. Now you have a bed for two people. Oh, you're on your side for this one. That's different. What about this side? I know both. Not only that, they're all available on small ships as well. Not as many blocks because you have a bit more freedom when it comes to small ships. Now you got the table for land or light right here. Take up a small area. 2x2 zone. They got the shelving, or the drawers, and then the table with nothing on it. So yeah, you can actually line these guys up next to each other. You have to get a longer table. So you can plop that one there. Yeah, plop you there. And you there. So you get a slightly longer table. Works better if it's larger. And then you got the bunk bed. Which, obviously there's only one version, because that's all you really need for a small ship. Just plop the same thing back on top. So there you got your bunk bed. And you can make that the size you want. Then again, I guess you could with that one too. Let's find out. And the bunk. Let's go back to this one. Plop you there. Plop you there. Yeah, it works. Anyway, oop. And then you got the wider bed and then the thinner bed. There's no double beds, unfortunately. Which is a bit of a shame. Oh, wait. Yeah, not available for small ships. This one is. Only small bed and master bed. What if you put the small beds together? Oh, okay. Yeah, you can, but they don't exactly connect to make a bigger bed. A bit of a shame, but oh well. That's what the build cost. 30 interior plates and 20 construction components. Just 10 construction components for the tables. That's not too bad. Same for these ones? Yeah, same. Material cost. They are basically just the same thing. Yeah. And you know, how about we take a look at the flat connectors? Or collectors. Yeah, you got the small one, and the medium, and large. Now these ones are those two are small ships only, well that's a large ship only. That connects to the small conveyors, that connects to the large conveyors, and that one's just for the large ships. And as you can tell, the big port on the back of the factory is on the base. Yeah. Probably set up a sequence of these to make a floor. And I can easily just drop off the mining materials and whatnot. That lightning. Oh well, whatever. So yeah, that's them. Their build cost. This one, oh my. 26. Hello? 26 steel plates, 20 construction components, 8 small steel tubes, 5 motors, 2 displays, and 5 computers. And that one's a bit more expensive. And this one's even more expensive. So yeah, the scale up in that cost as they get bigger. Obviously. Yeah, this will allow you to have some like low profile collectors. Which can be useful. So anyway, let's move on to the next one, which shouldn't take us too long because it's just passages. Except, I thought it would stop. So here are the sleek corridors. You see, it does look pretty nice. You got the basic straight one, you got the straight one with a light, so you can light up the passageways. And see, this one doesn't have anything there, but this one does. That's where the lights are. Then you got your basic corner one, a T-junction, and cross-section. Sort of thing. X-junction. What does it call it official? Corridor X. Corridor T, corner, straight, light, and normal straight. E. You just saw all the build cost right there. That's a weird number of interior plates. 74. 20 construction components, and 48 small steel tubes. Well, that's kind of weird. Oh well. There's some more lightning. And they all got the same build cost. Not bad. So if you ever decide to change your internal layout at any point, you just break it down and build it back up. Just handy. Noisy. Let me show you how that. So yeah, that's just these. Now, how about recoloring? But you want to see that. You see, it can already be recolored to red. It's not changing actively there, which is kinda not fun. Oh. You can change its color, but you can't change its material. What a shame. It would be kind of funny to have rust ones. Yeah. Oh well, never mind. So anyway, I'll have links for these three mods in the description below. as the weather is starting to change. It's getting a bit foggy. A little bit though. Just the beacons on the review pads. Oh, it's raining. And there's lightning up there. God dang it. Anyway, links for these three mods will be in the description below. And I hope you all enjoyed this video. If you have, please leave a like and even subscribe for episodes. And I shall see you all next time. Bye bye.